daughter Kelly for everything you have done for my family for many years. And Kelly, that was beautiful. Your playing was absolutely gorgeous, and I know how much my grandmother would love to play with you. Lila, for bringing food every Sunday for our family through my grandmother's illness. Judy, for coming all the way from Ocala each month to keep my grandparents' house sparkling. Gloria, thank you for styling my grandmother's hair and assisting me with her makeup for this service, and for all the years that you have kept both my grandparents looking handsome and beautiful. My grandmother's brother, Wayne Christie, is here with his daughter, Sandy McDermott, and they came all the way from Pennsylvania to join us here. Our cousin, Russ Young, who is my grandmother's sister, Shirley's son, say that 10 times fast, and his wife, Sherry, came from South Florida. My mother, Robin Keller, for setting aside all of her needs for the last year, for her want to be by my grandmother's side and to help take care of Grandpa too. I'm truly honored I could also assist you for the last 6 months and help any way I could. And last but not least, we want to thank each and every one of you here today for all of your love, your amazing dishes, and the outpouring of support through this tough time. The love I feel radiating from this room, from each and every one of you, reminds me what an amazing woman my grandmother was. Sorry, guys. It is impossible to put into words what my grandmother meant to me. She was truly an angel sent by God to bless my life for the last 42 years. She was the best testament to what living a life full of love, grace, and kindness truly means, and each and every day I strive to be half the woman, wife, mother, grandmother, and great-grandmother that she was. I don't remember a childhood holiday we didn't celebrate at their house. Grandpa's amazing pancakes, and Grandma always beating me at Scrabble. The many hours we all worked out in the yard, hiking the beautiful trails on their property, swinging on the swing that Grandpa built for us, and especially the time that I pushed my Grandma all over in the wheelbarrow, and we both laughed until we cried. And we might have peed our pants just a little bit. The many times I spent the night and my grandmother tucked me in snug as a bug as a rug, something like that, and would tell me her real life bedtime stories. She was always the first one by my side during a bad dream, and her amazing hot chocolate with marshmallows, her Eskimo kisses while rubbing my head always put me right back to sleep. The hundreds of hours with Grandma patiently teaching me how to play the piano and me begging her to just give me the certificate at the back of the book. She would say, sweetheart, with those glasses, sweetheart, all good things are earned and you learn to appreciate more what you've worked for the hardest. And she was right. I hung each and every certificate until my entire wall was covered. So many people have asked me if I ever heard my grandmother raise her voice at anyone, and the truth is I haven't. But I do have a few stories of how my grandmother's funk shined through. One story was when my grandmother was a teller at a bank. And honestly, I went back and forth of whether or not I was going to share this with you guys today.
Yes.
But for those of you that really knew my grandmother, you know she was a true woman of grace, but she also had humor for all situations. One of these was when she would get a very rude customer at the bank. You see, my grandmother would be extremely professional to the customer, but she would graciously just push her glasses in a gesture that would leave her coworkers in hysterics. Another story my grandmother told me before she put me to bed one night was a story about how her and my grandfather were bickering in the living room. And my grandfather would get his mean voice and say, woman, go to your room. And my grandma said she stomped back into her room and she sat down on the bed and she realized, what? You can't see me to my room. She marched back out to the living room with my grandfather rolling on the ground.
I remember that.
You didn't know she told me that story, did you, Grandpa? The true love my grandparents shared was like nothing I've ever seen. I'm sorry, I got to get there real fast, I'm sorry. Grandpa, leaving for the war, their many years trying to have a child, eventually adopting two precious children and loving them as their own. only to lose their youngest son at 27 years ago. But through all the trials and tribulations, I was there to witness their 70th wedding anniversary, which nowadays is unheard of, right? I could go on for hours about the memories I have with my grandmother. Grandma's zest for life, her unconditional love, and her kind spirit is what made her my hero. I refuse to live life in a bubble because each and every day she taught me was a gift. She warned me that life moves too fast, to stop and enjoy the moments more often. And I promise, Grandma, for you, I'm trying. I must have written 4 drafts of this, unsure of what would represent my grandmother the best. Then it hit me. Grandma's not the one I need to write this to. She and I have spoken on numerous occasions about how much she means to all of us. The special bond we have is something that will never be broken. I smile knowing she is with me now, enjoying her milkshake with that twinkle in her eye, nodding her head and assuring me that she'll always be by my side. So if this isn't for Grandma, then who is it for? Her other half, my grandpa. Grandpa, you are the living testament to the beauty that my grandmother was. She radiates within you. Grandpa, I wish I could take away the pain you feel losing Grandma. I know words cannot heal your wounds, but I want you to know, I promise you, every day you will witness living examples made present only because of the tremendous model you and Grandma set for us. As I tucked my grandmother into her bed, snug as a bug in a rug, and I rubbed her between the eyes, and then I made a comment to how funny my grandfather was. My grandmother took her last breath with a huge smile on her face. With her hand in mine, she went to be with the Lord. As we lay her down to rest, Grandpa, I want you to know this is merely a see you later. I don't believe in saying goodbye to her, for I know we will see her, feel her, and hold her close to our hearts. Grandma was a legend in all of our eyes. And as the Sandlot say, legends never die. Although we will all miss you so much that it hurts, I know we will see you later. Sweet dreams, Grandma. Snug as a bug in a rug, just like you used to say to me so many times before. I love you. Thank you.